أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، سورة القمر. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اقتربت الساعة وانشق القمر، وإن يروا آية يعرضوا ويقولوا سحر مستمر، وكذبوا واتبعوا أهواهم فكل أمر مستقر. صدق الله العظيم. As I told you, out of these seven surahs of this Makki group, the first one, Surah Qaf, is unique. It doesn't have any pair with it. But then Surah Zariyat and Surah Tur, they were a pair. In Surah Zariyat, we have the mention of the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, At-Tazkir bi-Ayyamillah. But it is not there in Surah Tur. Then Surah Al-Najm and Surah Al-Qamar are a pair. In Surah Al-Najm, we found that all the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His creations, His grace, they have been discussed. At-Tazkir bi-Ala'illah in detail, but not Tazkir bi-Ayyamillah. In this surah, you will find that. اقتربت الساعة وانشق القمر. The hour has drawn near and the moon was split asunder. That was the miracle of شق القمر that was shown by Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. It was perhaps in the fifth year after the beginning of Wahi, and the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم was sitting in Mina at a night, and there were people and they said, show us some miracle. So he said, okay, look to the moon. And he pointed with his finger and the moon split. And the two halves went away from each other. And there was a mountain. So one went to the side of the mountain and the other to the other side. But after some time, they again came together and joined. So this is a miracle. But you know, this was not on their demand that this miracle will be shown. We have found, you know, in the Surah Al-An'am and Surah Bani Israel, that when they mentioned that this miracle we want, that was not shown to them. But this is an exception that this Shakul Qabar was shown to them. And you know, there is a story that a Hindu Raja in Malabar, western coast of India, he was at that time, perchance, he was looking to the moon and he saw it, that the moon split into two and then came again together and it was joined together. So later on when he came to know about Islam and Quran and he read this, then he became Muslim. That is why we have, you know, on the western coast of the southern India, we have so many Muslims. وَيَرَوْا آيَةً And if they see a sign, يُعْرِضُوا They turn away from that. وَيَقُولُوا سَحْرٌ مُسْتَمِرٌ And they say it is a sorcery, it's a magic that has been coming from past. وَكَذَّبُوا And they belied. وَاتَّبَعُوا أَهْوَاهُمْ And they followed their caprices or their lusts or their desires. وَكُلُّ أَمْرٍ مُسْتَقِرٍ And every affair is to be settled at its appointed time. وَلَقَدْ جَاهُمْ مِنَ الْأَنْبَاءِ مَا فِيهِ مُزْدَجَرٍ And certainly there have come to them tidings in which there is a warning, perfect warning. حِكْمَةٌ بَالِغَةٌ فَمَا تُغْنِ النُّذُرِ A perfect wisdom, but warnings avail them not. فَتَوَلَّ عَنْهُمْ يَوْمَ يَدْعُ الدَّاعِ إِلَىٰ شَيْءٍ نُكَرٍ So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, just withdraw from them. Don't pay attention to them. And on that day, when the summoner or the caller from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will summon, and then there will be a horrible thing. They will be summoned to something which is very horrible. خُشْعَنْ أَبْصَارُهُمْ Their eyes will be downcast. يَخْرُجُونَ مِنَ الْأَجْدَاسِ And they will be coming out of their graves. كأنهم جراد منتشر as if they were locusts spread all over مهطعين إلى الداعي they will be running towards the caller يقول الكافرون and the disbelievers would say هذا يوم عصر this is a hard day they will recall that the messenger said that a day will come and this has come now كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح before them the people of Nuh also belied فكذبوا عبدنا they belied our servant Nuh وقالوا and said مجنون وازدجر he is a madman and he was rebuked and threatened فدعا ربه so he called to his lord أني مغلوب فانتصر I am going to be overpowered so oh Allah help me and vindicate me ففتحنا أبواب السماء بماء منهمر so we opened the gates of the heaven with water which was pouring down the rain was coming وفجرنا الأرض عيونا and then we made the earth to gush forth springs فالتقى الماء على أمر قد قدر So this water met each other. Water coming from the heaven in the form of rain and water coming from the springs which sprang from the earth. They met together for an affair that had already been ordained. وَحَمَلْنَاهُ عَلَىٰ ذَاتِ أَلْوَاحٍ وَدُسُرٍ And we bore him upon an ark made of planks of wood and nails. تَجْرِي بِعَيُنَنَا It was floating before our eyes. جَزَاءً لِمَنْ كَانَ كُفِرٍ And it was a reward for him who had been rejected. وَلَقَدْ تَرَكْنَاهَا آيَةً And we have left it to be a sign. فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكِرْ So is there anyone who will get admonished and who will get reminded? فَكَيْفَ كَانَ عَذَابِي وَنُذُرٍ So how terrible was my chastisement and my warnings. وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكِرْ And we have certainly made this Quran easy for admonition and reminding. But is there anyone who would be admonished? These words would be repeated here four times. وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرٍ Allah says, we have made this Quran very easy. For whosoever wants to be reminded, to have the true knowledge, he can very easily get it from Quran. But at least he has to put in some effort. He has to understand Arabic language and then read it. So he will get all the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كذبت عاد فكيف كان عذابي ونذر The عاد, the people of عاد also belied. So how terrible was my chastisement and my warnings. إنا أرسلنا عليهم ريحا صرصرا. We sent against them a raging wind. في يوم نحس مستمر. On a day of continuous ill luck. تنزع الناس. It was plucking the people away. كأنهم أعجاز نخل منقعر. As if they were the trunks of uprooted palm trees. فَكَيْفَ كَانَ عَذَابِي وَنُذُرٍ So how terrible was my chastisement and my warnings. وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرٍ We have made this Quran easy for admonition, for reminding. So is there anybody who wants admonition? كَذَّبَ السَّمُودَ بِالنُّذُرِ In the same way, the Samud, they belied the warners. فقالوا أبشرا منا they said a person a human being from amongst us واحدا and alone نتبعه should we follow him إنا إذا لفي ضلال وسعر if we follow him then we are in error and madness ألقي الذكر عليه من بيننا is the admonition being cast upon him alone among us بل هو كذاب نشير no he is an Impudent liar. He is a liar and rebellious. سَيَعْلَمُونَ غَدًا They will know tomorrow, inshallah, مَنِ الْكَذَّابُ الْأَشِيرُ Who is the liar and who is the rebellious? Either it was Saleh or those people who belied him. إِنَّا مُرْسِلُ النَّاقَةِ فِتْنَةً لَهُمْ We are going to send the she-camel as a trial for them. فَارْتَقِبْهُمْ وَاسْتَوِرْ So, O Saleh, now watch them and keep patience. وَنَبِّهُمْ And tell them, warn them. أن الماء قسمة بينهم that water is divided between them كل شرب محتضر every drink by turns one day this sea camel will drink the water from the well the whole of it and the other day you can bring your cattle and water them فنادوا صاحبهم then they called their comrade so فتعاتا so he took his sword فعقر and killed the sea camel فكيف كان عذابي ونذر So how terrible was my chastisement and my warnings. إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ سَيْحَةً وَاحِدَةً. We sent upon them a single shout. فَكَانُوا كَحَشِيمٍ مُحْتَظِرٍ. And they became the stubble of a pen builder. وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرٍ. Certainly we made Quran easy to get admonition from. But is there anybody who wants to have the admonition? كَذَّبَتْ قَوْمُ لُوطٍ بِالنُّذُرِ. In the same way, the people of Lut also denied the warnings. إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ حَاسِبًا. We sent upon them a stone storm. إِلَّا عَلَى لُوت. Except the family of Lut. نَجَّيْنَاهُمْ بِالسَّحَرِ. We delivered them at the dawn. نِعْمَةً مِنْ إِنْدِنَا. This was a blessing from us. كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي مَنْ شَكَرْ. In this way we recompense him who gives thanks. وَلَقَدْ أَنْزَرَهُمْ بَسَّتَنَا. And he had already warned them of our grip. فَتَمَارَوْا بِالنُّذُرْ. But they doubted the warnings. وَلَقَدْ رَاوَدُوهُ عَنْ ضَيْفِهِ. And certainly they asked him to hand them over, his guests, to them. They wanted, because the angels had come in the form of beautiful boys, handsome boys. وَلَقَدْ رَاوَدُوهُ عَنْ ضَيْفِهِ فَتَمَسْنَا عَيُنَهُمْ. But then we obliterated their sights. فَذُوقُوا عَذَابِي وَنُذُرُ. So now taste my chastisement and warnings. وَلَقَدْ صَبَّحَهُمْ بُكْرَةً عَذَابٌ مُسْتَقِرٌ. And certainly a lasting chastisement met them in the morning. فَذُوقُوا عَذَابِي وَنُذُرُ. So taste my chastisement and my warnings. وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرٍ. And definitely we have made Quran easy for admonition. But is there anyone who would be admonished? وَلَقَدْ جَاءَ عَلَى فِرْعَوْنَ النُّذُرُ. In the same way, warnings came to Fir'aun's people. كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا كُلِّهَا. They belied all our signs. فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ أَخْذَ عَزِيزٍ مُقْتَدِرٍ. So we seized them with the seizing of a mighty and powerful. أَكُفَّارُكُمْ خَيْرٌ مِنْ أُولَٰئِكُمْ. Now think, O Quraysh, are your disbelievers better than those? If Allah chastised them, finished them, destroyed them, why the same fate cannot come to you? أَكُفَّارُكُمْ خَيْرٌ مِنْ أُولَٰئِكُمْ. أَمْ لَكُمْ بَرَاءَةٌ فِي الزُّبُرِ. Are your disbelievers better than those? Or have you an immunity in the scriptures? Has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guaranteed you that no chastisement would come to you? أَمْ يَقُولُونَ نَحْنُ جَمِيعٌ مُنْتَصِرٌ. Do they say, we are a multitude, so we can take revenge and we can defend ourselves? سَيُهْزَمُ الْجَمْعُ وَيُوَلُّونَ الدُّبُرُ. Soon shall the multitude be routed and they shall turn their backs. بَلِ السَّاعَةُ مَوْعِدُهُمْ. But the hour is their promised time. وَالسَّاعَةُ أَدْهَى وَأَمَرُّ. And that hour is most calamitous and most bitter. إِنَّ الْمُجْرِمِينَ فِي ظَلَالٍ وَسُعُورٍ. The guilty will be in error and insanity. يَوْمَ يُسْحَبُونَ فِي النَّارِ. يَوْمَ يُسْحَبُونَ فِي النَّارِ عَلَى وُجُوهِهِمْ ذُوقُوا مَسَّ سَقَرَ. On the day when they shall be dragged on their faces into the fire. Taste now the touch of hell. إِنَّا كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَاهُ بِقَدَرٍ. Surely we have created everything in an estimated measure. وَمَا أَمْرُنَا إِلَّا وَاحِدَةٌ كَلَمْحٍ بِالْبَصَرِ. And our commandment is, but at once, as the twinkling of an eye. أَنْ نَقُولُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. وَلَقَدْ أَهْلَكْنَا أَشْيَاعَكُمْ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكِرٍ. And certainly we destroyed the likes of you. But is there anyone who would be admonished? وَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ فَعَلُوهُ فِي الزُّبُرِ. And everything that they have done is written in books. وَكُلُّ صَغِيرٍ وَكَبِيرٍ مُسْتَطَرٍ. And everything, small or great, is written down. إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ فِي جَنَّاتٍ وَنَهَرٍ. Surely, the God-fearing shall be in the gardens and rivers. فِي مَقْعَدِ صِدْقٍ عِنَّ مَلِيكٍ مُقْتَدِرٍ. In a true abode with a king who is omnipotent. اللهم ربنا اجعلنا منهم. Now we come to the most beautiful pair of these surahs. But please note two things. Number one, that these two surahs are very peculiar in the way, Suratul Rahman and Suratul Waqiyah, that there is no mention of any prophet, any messenger, any wahi. This, you know, one main article of faith, Nabuwah and Risala, is absolutely not mentioned here. Only Iman Billah, Tawheed of Allah, His attributes, His blessings, His grandeur, His majesty, the creation, all these things. And then the Akhirah, the Jannah and Jahannam, the hereafter and the hell and the garden or paradise. These two things are mentioned here. No mention of any wahi, any prophet, any rasul. It's very peculiar. These two surahs, Suratul Rahman and Suratul Waqia. Secondly, this surah, the first of them, Suratul Rahman, is most unique in the whole of Quran. That in this surah, the jinns and men, human beings, they are addressed simultaneously, absolutely parallel way. In the whole of the Quran, the jinns are not directly addressed in that way. But here, you know, this is for the jinns as well as humans. Absolutely parallel, absolutely equal. This is the only surah in the Quran where this address is to both of these creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, absolutely parallel and equal. And now these two surahs, if we have time today to finish both of them, you will find that the sequence of these surahs are like that of a mirror image. You know, a mirror image. You have certain buildings, houses made in a fashion. You know, they are mirror image to each other. A double house, if there is the garage, here is the garage. And you know, this is the drawing room, so this is the drawing room. Drawing rooms are together. Garages are on the ends. So this is called the mirror image. Sequence in these two surahs. In Suratul Rahman, in the very beginning, mention of Quran. In Suratul Waqia, in the end, mention of Quran and its grandeur. Then, in Suratul Rahman, after the mention of Quran, the grandeur of Allah's creation. And in Suratul Waqia, before the mention of Quran, in the end, you will find this grandeur of the creation of Allah. Then in Suratul Rahman, to start with, there is the mention of the people of the hell. And then you know the two grades of the people of garden. And the opposite sequence will you find over there. People of hell will be mentioned later, and the two grades of the people of the garden or Jannah, they will be earlier. So it's a mirror image. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ar-Rahman. The compassionate. Now this is ayah, complete, but not a sentence. Ar-Rahman allama al-Qur'an. Now the sentence is complete. But the ayahs are two. He has taught the Qur'an. You know, this Qur'an is his kalam, his speech. And he has taught. Khalaq al-insan. He has created man. Allamahu al-bayan. And taught him articulate speech. These four things are the topmost things. Out of the sacred and good names of Allah, Ar-Rahman is the most beautiful name. Because the source, the root is Rahmah, mercy. And Rahman, a mercy, you know, just as an ocean, you know, in storm. So that much mercy, you know. So this Rahman is the most lovable name. And as I've told you many a times, this was the name introduced by Quran. Allah, the name of Allah, was very well known to the Arabs. And they used it. But Rahman, you know, it was introduced by Quran. Now, Allama al-Quran, all the knowledge which we have is from Allah. But the highest knowledge is the knowledge of Quran. Number three, Khalaq al-Insan. Well, he has created heavens, earth, sun, moon, angels, jinns, all. But the climax of his creation is man. Allamahu al-bayan. He has given us many faculties. We can see, but the animals can also see. Some of them can see better than ourselves. All the other faculties are common. But the highest faculty given to man is articulate speech. Allamahu al-bayan. So these are four things. Ar-Rahman, the most beautiful name. Allama al-Quran, the highest knowledge is Quran. Khalaq al-insan, insan, man is the climax of creation of Allah. Allamahu al-bayan, and this faculty of expressing yourself, articulate speech, is the highest faculty endowed to human beings. So now there is a result of these three sentences. Ayat are four, sentences are three. Ar-Rahmanu allama al-Quran, khalaqa al-insan, allamahu al-bayan. Now you can guess what should be the fourth. By the method of ratio proportion, a method in arithmetic which might, if you recall during your school days, fourth value is that the best use of this faculty of bayan is to explain Quran. The best faculty should be used for the highest knowledge. And that is what the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. Whosoever among you, he devotes himself to understanding of Quran and then teaching of Quran, he is the highest and best amongst you. الشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ بِحُسْبَانِ. The sun and the moon follow their computed courses. وَالنَّجْمُ وَالشَّجَرُ يَسْجُدَانِ. And the stars and the trees prostrate before Allah. وَالسَّمَاءَ رَفَعَهَا. And the heaven he has raised high. وَوَضَعَ الْمِيزَانِ. And he has set the balance. Mostly people think this balance is justice in this world. I have a different opinion. I understand that this is the cosmic balance. The cosmic balance between the planets. This is mutual balance. The gravity forces, they balance each other. If there's any difference in the course of when one planet, they will collide together. So this universe, this space, and all this, this is based on a cosmic balance. Allah tadghaw fil mizan, that don't disturb this cosmic balance. وَاقِيمُ الْوَزْنَ بِالْقِسْطِ وَلَا تُخْسِرُ الْمِيزَانِ. And establish, keep the balance with equity. And don't let the balance be lost. وَالْأَرْضَ وَدَعَهَا لِلْأَنْعَامِ. Now we come to the earth. All this was for the space and the planets and the galaxies. Now وَالْأَرْضَ وَدَعَهَا لِلْأَنْعَامِ. And the earth, he laid it down for the creatures. فِيهَا فَاكِهَا. Therein it is, there are fruits. وَالنَّقْلُ ذَاتُ الْأَكْمَانِ. And the palm trees having sheaths. وَالْحَبُّ ذُو الْعَصْفِ. And the grain in the husk. وَالرَّحَانِ. And the fragrant plants. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. So which of the bounties and graces of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala you will belie? تُكَذِّبَانِ is tasniya, two, addressed to jinns and men. خَلَقَ الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ صَلْصَالٍ كَالْفَخَّارِ. He created man out of a ringing clay, like the potter's clay. وَخَلَقَ الْجَانَّ مِنْ مَارِجٍ مِنْ نَارِ. And he created the jinn from a smokeless fire. فَبِأَيَّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. Now this ayah will be repeated 31 times. I'm not going to translate every time. I've translated. So which of the blessings and bounties and graces of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will you belie? So we don't need to translate again and again. Maraj al-Bahrain yaltaqiyan. He set forth the two seas or currents side by side. Bainahuma barzakhun la yabghiyan. Between them is a barrier. They don't intermingle and then don't overpass. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. يَخْرُجُ مِنْهُمَا اللُّؤْلُؤُ وَالْمَرْجَانِ. From both of them, the bitter current and the sweet current, side by side. But from both of them, come out the pearls and the corals. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. وَلَهُ الْجَوَارِ الْمُنْشَآتُ فِي الْبَحْرِ كَالْأَعْلَامِ. And his are the ships sailing upon the sea, raised up like mountains. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. كُلُّ مَنْ عَلَيْهَا فَانٍ. Everyone who is there will pass away. وَيَبْقَى وَجْهُ رَبِّكَ ذُو الْجَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ. But only the face of your Lord will abide forever, forever. Owner of majesty and splendor. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. يَسْأَلُهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Everyone who is there in the heavens and the earth, they beg him always. كُلَّ يَوْمٍ هُوَ فِي شَانٍ. And each day he is upon a new sublime state. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. سنفرغ لكم أيها الثقلان. O two great creatures, ثقلان, men and jinns, أيها الثقلان, we shall soon attend to you. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان. يا معشر الجن والإنس, O the assemblies of jinn and mankind, إن استطعتم, if it is possible for you, أن تنفذوا من أقطار السماوات والأرض, that you pass beyond the boundaries of the heavens and the earth. فانفذوا, then pass. لا تنفذون إلا بسلطان. You will not be able to pass through these boundaries except with our authority. What does it mean? From the boundaries of heavens and earth to go out, what does it mean? The heavens and the earth is the whole universe. This is the whole existence. This means if you want to perish, you want that you should not be there anymore, you can't do it. In Jahannam, people will like that there should be some end to our existence. We don't want to exist, but you have to exist. You can't, you know, be destroyed absolutely and finished in existence. Your existence will remain. Unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at some time, He decides to do it, He can do it. فَبِأَيَّ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ يُرْسَلُ عَلَيْكُمَا شُوَعَزٌ مِّن نَارٍ وَنُحَاسٌ فَلَا تَنْتَصِرَانِ There shall be sent against you both flames of fire and smoke, and you will not be able to defend yourself. فَبِأَيَّ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ فَإِذَا انشَقَّتِ السَّمَاءُ And when the heaven will be split asunder, فَكَانَتْ وَرْدَةٌ كَالدِّهَانِ And it will become as red as the hides of the people, of the animals. فَبِأَيَّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ فَيَوْمَئِذٍ لَا يُسْأَلُ عَن ذَنْبِهِ إِنسٌ وَلَا جَانٌّ On that day, neither the jinns nor the mankind will be asked or questioned about their sins. What does it mean? There will be no need of asking them. It will be written on their faces. يُعْرَفُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ بِسِيمَاهُمْ The guilty and the culprits will be recognized by their face marks. فَيُوْخَذُ بِالنَّوَاسِي وَالْأَقْدَامِ So they will be seized with their forelocks, hair, and their feet. Hair and feet, and thrown into the fire. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ هَذِهِ جَهَنَّمُ الَّتِي يُكَذِّبُ بِهَا الْمُجْرِمُونَ This is the hell which the guilty had been belying. يَتُوفُونَ بَيْنَهَا وَبَيْنَ حَبِيبِنَانِ Now they will keep rotating between it and the hot boiling water. When they are in the fire, They become thirsty, go out, but there, you know, their thirst is quenched by boiling water. Again run there. So they will be going on between these two things, to this and that. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ وَلِمَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ جَنَّتَانِ On the contrary, for those who had feared their Lord, there should be two gardens. Why two gardens? I have not found these things in any of the tafasir or translation. These things have come to my mind. If they are correct, I thank Allah. If they are wrong, I pray to Him that He should rectify me. Two gardens, why? One for the jinns, one for the humans. They are made of different material. Their temperaments are different. So the garden should be separate for the jinns and the humans. وَلَمَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ جَنَّتَانِ فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ سَوَاتَ أَفْنَانِ Abounding in branches, branches. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ فِيهِمَا عِنَانُ تَجْرِيَانِ In them there will be two fountains flowing. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ فِيهِمَا مِنْ كُلِّ فَاكِهَةٍ زَوْجَانِ In those gardens there will be every fruit of two kinds. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ مُتَّكِئِينَ عَلَىٰ فُرُشٍ بَطَائِنُهَا مِنْ إِسْتَبْرَقٍ Reclining upon couches lined with brocade. وَجَنَى الْجَنَّتَيْنِ دَانِ And the fruit of both gardens will be just near at hand. They can pluck it as they desire. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ فِيهِنَّ قَاصِرَاتُ الطَّرْفِ لَمْ يَطْمِثْهُنَّ إِنْسٌ قَبْلَهُمْ وَلَا جَانٌ In those gardens will be the maidens of restraining glances. Whom neither men will have touched before them, nor any jinn. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ كأنهن الياقوت والمرجان. They were so beautiful as if they were the rubies and corals. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ هل جزاء الإحسان إلا الإحسان؟ What can be the recompense of good but good? They did good deeds, so they are getting good, you know, things from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان؟ ومن دونهما جنتان. And beyond them will be two more gardens. Now this is for the higher level of the people of Jannah. Two levels. In Surah Al-Waqiyah we shall find Ashabul Yameen and Muqarrabun. Those who will be very near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Two levels of the Mu'mineen, of the believers. And here also. وَمِن دُونِهِمَا جَنَّتَانِ And beyond them there will be two more gardens. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ مُدْهَامَّتَانِ They will be dark green with foliage. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ فِيهِمَا عَيْنَانِ نَضَّاخَتَانِ There will be two fountains gushing strongly. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ فِيهِمَا فَاكِهَةٌ وَنَخْلٌ وَرُمَّانِ In them will be the fruits and the palm trees and the pomegranates. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ فِيهِنَّ خَيْرَاتٌ حِسَانٌ There in them will be the maidens who will be very beautiful. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ حُورٌ مَقْصُورَاتٌ فِي الْخِيَامِ Huris, well guarded in tents and pavilions. Now note, about the first Jannah, the word Hur didn't appear. But the second Jannah, this word Hur is coming. There's some difference. You will note it again in Surah Waqiyah. Hurum maqsuratun fil khiyam, the Huris, well guarded in pavilions and tents. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ لَمْ يَطْمِثْهُنَّ إِنْسٌ قَبْلَهُمْ وَلَا جَانٌ Them nobody will have touched before, neither men nor jinn. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ مُتَّكِئِينَ عَلَىٰ رَفْرَفٍ خُضْرٍ وَعَبْقَرِيٍّ حِسَانٍ Reclining upon green cushions and lovely colorful carpets. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ تَبَارَكَ اسْمُ رَبِّكَ ذِي الْجَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ Blessed is the name of your Lord, O Prophet, the owner of majesty and honor. Now Surah Al-Waqi'ah. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Iza waqa'atil waqi'ah. Laysa li waqa'atiha kaziba. Khafizatul rafi'ah. Iza rujjatil ardu rajjan. Babustatil jibalu bassan. Fakanat haba'an munbassan. You see the rhythm, you know. This is the beauty. Literary beauty. When the event will happen. The event. Waqi'ah. Means as-sa'ah. لَيْسَ لِوَقَّتِهَا كَاذِبَةً There is no belying in its happening. It will happen, it will come. خَافِذَةُ الرَّافِعَةً It will humiliate some and raise some. When this event comes, some people will be humiliated, degraded, and some will be honored and exalted. إِذَا رُجَّتُ الْأَرْضُ رَجَّنْ When the earth will be shaken with a severe shaking, وَبُسَّتِ الْجِبَالُ بَسَّنْ And the mountains will be crumbled to pieces and powdered. فَكَانَتْ هَبَامٌ بَسَّنْ And they will become like scattered dust. وَكُنْتُمْ أَزْوَاجًا سَلَاسَةً And you, O mankind, will be divided into three bands, three groups. فَأَصْحَابُ الْمَيْمَنَةِ مَا أَصْحَابُ الْمَيْمَنَةِ So the companions of the right, How happy shall be the companions of the right? وَأَصْحَابُ الْمَشَّمَةِ مَا أَصْحَابُ الْمَشَّمَةِ And the companions of the left, how wretched shall be the condition of the companions of the left? وَالسَّابِقُونَ السَّابِقُونَ And the foremost will be the foremost. أُولَٰئِكَ الْمُقَرَّبُونَ They shall be brought very near to the Lord. فِي جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ In the gardens of bliss. سُلَّةُ مِنَ الْأَوَّلِينَ A multitude from the ancients. وَقَلِيلٌ مِنَ الْآخِرِينَ And only a few from the later generations. عَلَىٰ سُرُرٍ مَوْزُونَةٍ On couches woven with gold and precious stones. تَكَيْنَ عَلَيْهَا مُتَقَابِلِينَ Reclining on them, facing each other. يَتُوفُ عَلَيْهِمْ وِلْدَانُ مُخَلَّدُونَ And there shall pass around them immortal youths. بأكواب وأباريق وكاسم من معين with goblets and jugs and a cup from a clear wine. لا يصدعون عنها ولا ينزفون. They will not suffer heaviness nor will they be intoxicated by that wine. وفاكهة مما يتخيرون. And such fruits as they will choose and order. ولحم طير مما يشتهون. And the flesh of the fowl, the birds, as they desire. وحور عين. And there will be wide-eyed houris. كأمثال اللؤلؤ المكنون. Like the hidden pearls. جزاء بما كانوا يعملون. A reward or recompense for what they used to do. لا يسمعون فيها لغوا ولا تاسيما. They will not listen, they will not have to hear in that no vain talk nor of any sin. إلا قيلا سلاما سلاما. Except the saying peace and peace and peace. These angels will be coming and saluting them. Peace. So this was the highest level, مقربون. This was mentioned in Surah Al-Rahman in the end. Here it is the first thing. The mirror image. Now, وَأَصْحَابُ الْيَمِينَ مَا أَصْحَابُ الْيَمِينَ. And as for the companions of the right, how happy shall be the companions of the right. The lower degree of the people of Jannah. That is the highest, مُقَرَّبُونَ. Now these, فِي سِدْرٍ مَقْبُودٍ. Amid thornless low trees. وَتَلْحٍ مَنْضُودٍ. And clustered banana trees. وَزِلٍ مَمْدُودٍ. And the spreading shades. وَمَاءٍ مَسْكُوبٍ. And the water flowing. وَفَاكِهَةٍ كَثِيرَةٍ. And fruits abundant. لَا مَقْطُوعَةٍ وَلَا مَمْنُوعَةٍ. Neither ending nor forbidden. وَفُرُشٍ مَرْفُوعَةٍ. And couches upraised. إِنَّا أَنْشَأْنَاهُنَّ إِنْشَاءً. We have created them, their spouses. But here the word hoor doesn't appear. We have created them by special creation. فَجَعَلْنَاهُنَّ أَبْكَارًا. We have made them virgins. عُرُبًا أَتْرَابًا. Loving, equals of age. لِأَصْحَابِ الْيَمِينَ. For the companions of the right. سُلَّةٌ مِنَ الْأَوَّلِينَ. A multitude from the ancients. وَسُلَّةٌ مِنَ الْآخِرِينَ. And a multitude from the later generations also. So most of us, if Allah blesses us, can hope to be from among this group. The former group was for the people who were nearer to the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sunnatun min al-awwaleen, the Sahaba and Tabi'een, and only very few from the later generations. But as for Ashabul Yameen, multitude from the former, multitude from the later. Wa Ashabul Shimal ma Ashabul Shimal. And the companions of the left, how wretched shall be the companions of the left? Fi samumin, in the burning winds, wa hamimin, in boiling waters, wa zillim min yahmumin, and the shade of dark smoke, la baridin wa la kareem, neither cool nor pleasant. Innahum kanu qabla zalika mutrafeen. Surely they were before coming here in the year after, in the world they were affluent, they were rich. وَكَانُوا يُصِرُّونَ عَلَى الْحِنْسِ الْعَظِيمِ. And they used to persist in the greatest sin, that is shirk. وَكَانُوا يَقُولُونَ. And they used to say, أَيْذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا. When we shall die and we shall become only dust, وَعِزَامًا, and bones, أَيْنَّا لَمَبُوسُونَ. Shall we be resurrected? أَوَعَبَعُنَا الْأَوَّلُونَ. And also our ancient fathers, they will be resurrected. All. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّ الْأَوَّلِينَ وَالْآخِرِينَ. Verily, the ancients and those of later generations, لَمَجْمُعُونَ, they will all be gathered, إِلَى مِيقَاتِ يَوْمٍ مَعْلُومٍ, at the appointed time of the known day. ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ أَيُّهَا الضَّالُّونَ الْمُكَذِّبُونَ. Then surely you, O the erring ones, belying people, لَآكِلُونَ مِنْ شَجَرٍ مِنْ زَقُومٍ. You will have to eat from the tree of Zakum. فَمَالِئُونَ مِنْهَا الْبُطُونَ. And you will have to fill your bellies with it. فَشَارِبُونَ عَلَيْهِ مِنَ الْحَمِيمِ. And then you shall drink on top of that boiling water. فالشاربون شرب الحين and you'll be drinking it as the drinking of a thirsty camel. هذا نزلهم يوم الدين. This will be the hospitality offered to them on the day of recompense. Now come the creation, majesty of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which we find in the first section of Surah Ar-Rahman. Here it is coming in the latest. نحن خلقناكم فلولا تصدقون. We have created you. Why do you not admit the truth and believe in the messenger and the resurrection? أفرأيتم ما تمنون. Do you consider the human semen which you emit? أنتم تخلقونه أم نحن الخالقون. Do you create them or we are the creators? Who creates them in the wombs of their mothers? You just emitted the semen and that's all. What's your role? Who creates them? Antum takhluqunahu. Are you shaping them from one shape to other? Am nahnu al-khaliqun. Now there are going to be several questions like this. And after each such question, we should reply, Bal anta ya Rab. No, no. Oh, our Lord, you do it. Not us. We don't do it. It's your deed. نَحْنُ قَدَّرْنَا بَيْنَكُمُ الْمَوْتَ وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمَسْبِقِينَ. We have ordained among you death and we are not be overcome. أَلَا نُبَدِّلَ أَمْسَالَكُمْ. That we may change your forms. وَنُنْشِيَكُمْ فِي مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. And we create you again in forms you know not. You know, when we die, these bodies of ours will be disintegrated. Now new bodies will be given, not these bodies. This body is ever changing. This body of mine today, it's not the same body that it was yesterday. Many of my cells have died, new have been created. My blood, how many millions of the red blood corpuscles have died? New have been created. So there's a continuous change going on. Then I was young, of robust health. Now I'm old, gray hair. So actually this body will disintegrate. Another body will be given with another physical loss. And here it is said, نُبَدَّلَ أَمْسَالَكُمْ. But they will be like you. But Allah will create them. And نُنْشِيَكُمْ فِي مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Now that form that you'll get for the hereafter, you can't understand. وَلَقَدْ عَلِمْتُمُ النَّشْرَةَ الْأُولَى. But you have known absolutely the first creation from a sperm drop to a full human being. فَلَوْلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. So why don't you get the admonishing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who created from the sperm drop a full man, even Socrates and Plato and Alexander the Great and so on and so forth, from that drop of sperm. Why can't he create again the like of them? Now number two. أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تَحْرُسُونَ. Have you considered that which you sow in the field? أَنْتُمْ تَزْرَعُونَهُ أَمْ نَحْنُ الزَّارِعُونَ. Do you make them grow or we do it? What do? You have sown the seeds, that's all. Who is making it grow? Have you any contribution? Bal anta ya Rab. Bal anta ya Rab. Oh Lord, you do it. Law nasha'u laja'alnahu hutaman. If we will, we could make it a calf. Fadaltum tafakkahoon, and then you will remain lamenting. Inna lamughramoon. We have been laden with debts. We had invested so much in this, and this is gone. Destroy it. بَلْ نَحْنُ مَحْرُومُونَ. Nay, we have been deprived. Number three. أَفَرَأَيْتُمُ الْمَاءَ الَّذِي تَشْرَبُونَ. Have you ever considered this water that you drink? أَنْتُمْ أَنْزَلْتُمُوهُ مِنَ الْمُزْنِ أَمْ نَحْنُ الْمُنْزِلُونَ. Have you sent it down from the clouds or we are the senders? بَلْ أَنْتَ يَا رَبْ. Oh Lord, it's you, not us. لَوْ نَشَاءُ جَعَلْنَاهُ أُجَاجًا. Had we willed, we would have made it bitter. فَلَوْلَا تَشْكُرُونَ. Why don't you thank us? Number four. أفرأيتم النار التي تورون. Do you consider the fire that you kindle? أأنتم أنشأتم شجرتها أم نحن المنشئون؟ Have you grown the trees for that? Or we have done this? بل أنت يا رب. نحن جعلناها تذكرة. We have made it a sign, a reminder, ومتان للمقوين. And boon for the dwellers of the desert. In the desert there is a special plant. By rubbing the branches, green branches, fire comes out. And the same, you know, bamboo trees, when they are young, if you rub them, fire comes out. So from green trees, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is mentioned in Surah Yasun also and here also. فَسَبِّحْ بِسْمِ رَبِّكَ الْعَظِيمِ. So you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, glorify the name of your Lord who is great. فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِمَوَاقِعِ النُّجُومِ. Now here are 8 ayats regarding Quran. Very stern, very stiff. I told you that was in the beginning, 4. الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان. So that he should be able to express and teach and propagate Quran. We gave him the faculty of bayan so that he should propagate and convey the knowledge and wisdom of this Quran. Now, فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِمَوَاقِعِ النُّجُومِ. Nay, I swear by the places of the setting of the stars. وَإِنَّهُ لَقَسَمُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى مُنْعَظِيمُ. And this is a mighty oath. Only if you could know. This is very important. Today we can know. But when Quran was coming down, people couldn't know what it means. Now we have the concept of black holes in the space. Big stars. They shrink. Become a point. And there is a hole. Everything which passes thereby, it is drawn into it and finished. These are the black holes in the space. Full galaxies have already disappeared. So this is فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِمَوَاقِعِ النُّجُومِ. See the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking this oath. No, I swear by the places where the stars go down. وَإِنَّهُ لَقَسَمُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى مُنْعَظِيمُ. Only if you could know, this is a very mighty oath. إِنَّهُ لَقُرْآنٌ كَرِيمٌ. And now what? On what this oath? Verily this Qur'an. This is a very honorable Qur'an. فِي كِتَابٍ مَكْنُونٍ. It is in the hidden book. This is not Qur'an. This is a copy of Qur'an. The real Qur'an. وَإِنَّهُ فِي أُمِّ الْكِتَابِ لَدَيْنَا لَعَلِيٌّ حَكِيمٌ. Surah Al-Dukhan, we have read already. The real book is there. فِي أُمِّ الْكِتَابِ. And then we shall read in the last part. فِي لَوْحٍ مَحْفُوظٍ. بَلْ هُوَ قُرْآنُ الْمَجِيدِ فِي لَوْحٍ مَحْفُوظٍ. The protected, preserved tablet. And here it is. إِنَّهُ لَقُرْآنٌ كَرِيمٌ فِي كِتَابٍ مَكْنُونٍ. لا يمسه إلا المطهرون. Nobody can touch it but the only most purified people. Who are those? They are the angels. This is the book over there with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His presence. Who can touch them? Touch that book? The angels. Absolutely free of sin. Absolutely free of sin. مطهرون. Who have been purified. Now, from this ayah, a legal question has been derived, legal issue, that we shouldn't touch Quran except when we are pure with wuzu. This is correct. But this ayah means something else. This is referring to that Quran. This can be touched only by the most pure and the highest level, Malaikatul Muqarrabun. Only they can touch it. بِأَيْدِي سَفَرَةٍ كِرَامٍ بَرَرَةٍ. In the last part again we shall have it, the mention of it. إِنَّهُ لَقُرْآنٌ كَرِيمٌ فِي كِتَابٍ مَمْنُونٌ لَا يَمَسُّهُ إِلَّا الْمُطَهَّرُونَ. And there is another meaning of this, لَا يَمَسُّهُ إِلَّا الْمُطَهَّرُونَ. Nobody can reach the essence of Quran unless he has purified himself. You might have remembered it. Just as the Quran is there on the tape recorder, it can be in my mind, in somebody's mind, some hafiz's tongue, but that doesn't mean he has the Quran. One might be a scholar, can write books and books and books on Quran, but it doesn't touch the nucleus of Quran. Cannot go. To go to the nucleus of Quran, to the inner meaning of Quran, you have to purify yourself first. That is why we find in Quran first tazkiyah and then ta'lim. هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة. تزكية must precede education. Otherwise you will have gathered a lot of education, a lot of information in your brain, the memory of your computer, but to no avail, you won't be able to absorb it into the depths of your personality. For that you have to purify yourself first. لا يمسه إلا المطهرون. There is a couplet of Allama Iqbal, I don't remember the first sentence. It says that although the angel comes and takes away your life, تیرے وجود کے مرکز سے دور رہتا ہے. The angel cannot touch. فرشتہ موت کا چھوتا ہے گو بدن تیرا. تیرے وجود کے مرکز سے دور رہتا ہے. You might be learning Quran and this and that, but you know the heart of Quran, the essence of Quran, that you can't touch unless you have purified your intentions. للہیت, to live for God, to die for God. من احب للہ وابغض للہ واعطى للہ ومنع للہ فقد استقبل الایمان. A very famous hadith. Whomsoever, if he gives something, he gives for the pleasure of Allah. If he holds back something, he holds back for the pleasure of Allah. If he loves someone, he loves only for the pleasure of Allah. If he hates someone, he hates him only for the pleasure of Allah, not for his own nafs. So such a person has completed his iman. فَقَدْ اسْتَكْمَلَ الْإِيمَانِ. اللَّهُمَّ جَعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ. All our actions to be motivated only by the love of Allah. No other motivation. If I give something to my own body, this is because Allah has said that this is the right of your body. وَإِنَّ لِنَفْسِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقًّا. Your own nafs has also a right on you. One thing is that I am giving it to my nafs because my nafs demands, and I love my nafs. So I am obeying the demand of my nafs and providing it with it. The other is that my Lord has fixed the right of my nafs also on me. So I have to cater to its need. The motivation is changed. Although you might be doing the same thing, but the motivation is changed absolutely. فلا أقسم بمواقع النجوم وإنه لقسم لو تعلمون عظيم إنه لقرآن كريم في كتاب مكنون لا يمسه إلا المطهرون تنزيل من رب العالمين. Its revelation and sending down is from the Lord of all the worlds. أفبهذا الحديث أنتم مدهنون. Now this is a question, piercing question. What? So is this the recital, this bounty of Allah, that you are taking lightly? Can't learn Arabic to understand this book? How much importance have you given to this book? Can't learn Arabic. So as to be able to read it directly with your own eyes. How much time do you devote to understand this book? أفبهذا الحديث أنتم مدهنون. مداهنت not paying its paying it its due. You know, I started my movement in 1965 with a booklet, Muslimano par Quran Majid ke huquq, the obligations Muslims owe to Quran. It's the most fundamental pamphlet with which I started my mission. It's now 35 years back. What are the rights of Quran over us? Do we fulfill? What's the value which we attach to Quran? أَفَبِهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ أَنْتُمْ مُدْهِنُونَ وَتَجْعَلُونَ رِزْقَكُمْ أَنَّكُمْ تُكَذِّبُونَ. And you have decided that your portion from it will be that you are denying it. If you are not fulfilling the rights of Quran over you, you are denying Quran. Had you really believed that this is Allah's word, could you take it so lightly? If a letter comes to you from President Clinton, how do you feel? This book, Love from Allah, is there, placed on some high place in your house. You have learned everything, all the trades, business and computer and this and that, and engineering and medicine, not Quran. وَتَجَلُونَ رِزْقَكُمْ أَنَّكُمْ تُكَذِّبُونَ. This is belying Quran by action. By tongue you say, I believe in Quran, this is the word of Allah. But your action, your attitude, your behavior says you don't believe it. Otherwise you couldn't have taken it so indifferently and so lightly. فَلَوْلَا إِذَا بَلَغَتِ الْحُلْقُونَ. So why then? When the soul reaches up the throat of the dying person, when a person is dying, you know, and then here in this throat, a special type of sound comes out from here. Gargaras. When the soul reaches up to the throat of the dying, وَأَنْتُمْ هِنَا إِذِنْ تَنْزُرُونَ. And at that time, you are watching him. Your father is going before your eyes. He's going. Can you save him from the death? You are seeing, you are standing, can't do anything. Your beloved son, maybe the only son, is going. Someone is there taking it away from you. Can you take him back? فَلَوْلَا إِذَا بَلَغَتِ الْحُلْقُومِ وَأَنْتُمْ هِنَا إِذِنْ تَنْزُرُونَ. You are there seeing, watching. وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْكُمْ وَلَكِنْ لَا تُبْصِرُونَ. At that time, we are nearer to him than you, but you can't see. The angels have already come to receive him, but you can't see them. فَلَوْلَا إِن كُنْتُمْ غَيْرَ مَدِينِينَ. Then why? If you are not obligated to us, you are not subordinate to us, تَرْجِعُونَهَا إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Why don't you bring it back if you are truthful? Bring the life of your father, bring the life of your son. Do you have any authority? No. You are totally subjected to us. لائی حیات آئے قضا لے چلی چلے. اپنی خوشی سے آئے نہ اپنی خوشی چلے. It was the decree by the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأَمَّا إِن كَانَ مِنَ الْمُقَرَّبِينَ. Now the three groups, a lasting mention is made. So if the one who dies before your eyes, if he be of those from مقربين who are going to be very near to Lord, فَرَاحٌ وَرَيْحَانٌ وَجَنَّةُ نَحِيمٌ. For them there will be rest and ease and garden of bliss. وَأَمَّا إِنْ كَانَ مِنَ أَصْحَابِ الْيَمِينَ. And if he is one of the companions of the right, فَسَلَامٌ لَكَ مِنَ أَصْحَابِ الْيَمِينَ. Then be in peace regarding the companions of the right. They will also be in comfort. You don't have to worry for them. وأما إن كان من المكذبين الضالين. But as for whom? As for him who was from among the liars and astraying ones, gone astray and belying the revelation of Allah and the message of the Messenger. فَنُزُلٌ مِّنْ حَمِيمٍ. So then the hospitality will begin with boiling water. وَتَسْلِيَةُ جَحِيمٍ. And then the roasting in the hellfire. إِنَّ هَذَا لَهُوَ حَقُّ الْيَقِينِ. Believe it, surely this is the truth of certainty. It is no stories. It's not the fables of the ancients. It's reality. It will happen. فَصَبِّحْ بِاسْمِ رَبِّكَ الْعَظِيمِ. So glorify the name of your Lord, the Mighty. سُبْحَانَ رَبِّيَ الْعَظِيمِ. بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ وَنَفَعَنِي وَإِيَّاكُمْ بِالْآيَاتِ وَالذِّكْرِ الْحَكِيمِ.
الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us. or call our toll-free number, 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together, we can make a difference.